Apple's newest iPad mini came out at the end of September, and I've been using it for a month, and for the most part, I really like it. This is technically the mini's sixth generation, but Apple has just been calling it the iPad mini. It starts at $499 with 64 gigabytes of storage. Ah, yes, still selling products with 64 gigabytes of storage. Ugh. You can upgrade the storage, but the only other option is 256 gigabytes, and that comes with an expensive $150 price increase. 5G connectivity is an option here, but that is yet again another, you guessed it, $150 price increase. Apple is a lot of things, but cheap ain't one of them. It's available in space gray, pink, purple, and starlight. I bought the starlight version, and it's pretty much just silver. I had hoped it would be sort of a new hybrid silver slash gold color, but it's not.
False.
But I'm happy to say that this new iPad mini came with a design refresh and what Apple is calling an all-screen design. You get an 8.3-inch LED screen, a fingerprint sensor on the top, volume buttons on the top next to that, and stereo speakers. It looks like there's four speakers, but sound actually only comes out of two of them. There's support for the Apple Pencil 2 if you want to sketch or take notes, and it magnetically attaches to the side, and I didn't buy it. It charges via USB-C, and it comes with a USB-C charging cable and...
What's this?
The charging brick. So Apple can still include those in the box. I guess they only really care about the environment when it comes to their phones. The new design looks like the new iPad Pro and iPad Air with a slimmer, uniform bezel around the edges, and I really like it. It still feels a little thick, but it does give you a place to pick up the mini without accidental touches. Overall, it's really sleek looking and sharp. Only have a couple issues with the new design. The sharp edges that match the newer iPhones look really nice, but it's just not comfortable to hold or maneuver in your hands. This thing is just begging for a case. It feels sturdy and well built, but I was terrified I was going to drop this thing the whole month I was using it. My only other build complaint is the location of the volume buttons. Their location makes using them a little awkward. The tablet is small, but you can't get away with one-handed usage because you'll have to hold it with one hand and slide your hand up to reach them or reach across with your other hand. It's just not user-friendly, and I hate it and want it to die. So this new mini is powered by the A15 Bionic chip, which is nearly identical to the chip in the new iPhone 13 Pro, but it's just slightly underclocked. What this means is really great performance in everyday use. The larger screen is great for consuming content and apps open quickly, and it shouldn't struggle with mobile gaming or some photo editing. I wouldn't really recommend it for video editing, but it probably could get by. With heavy use like watching shows, YouTube, and browsing the internet, I was able to get about a day to a day and a half of use before needing to recharge. The included 20-watt charger was able to go from 0 to 100% in a little under 2 hours. It's decent speed, but not as fast as it could be. I think the most impressive thing I found regarding the battery was the standby time. At one point, I didn't use the tablet for like a few days, and it only drained 3% off the battery. So, to sum it up, great performance, good enough battery life. The mini comes with a single front and back camera. The rear lens is a 12-megapixel wide-angle lens that can also record up to 4K 60 frames per second. It's got your typical iPhone camera features like slow-mo, time-lapse, and HDR. Shots are decent, but can't quite match the iPhone 13. I don't see this as a huge deal, as most people probably won't be taking a ton of photos with their tablet. The front camera is a 12-megapixel ultra-wide lens that supports Apple's new center stage feature, which keeps your subject centered as they move around the frame. It's a cool feature and all, but all it's really doing is cropping in on the ultra-wide lens, then moving the crop to follow you throughout the original 122-degree field of view. You can make FaceTime calls and record it up to 1080p 60 frames per second. As I said, most people probably aren't too concerned with the camera quality on a tablet, but it's good to have these options if you need them. So who should buy the iPad mini? That's a tricky question. The main selling point of this mini is the small size. You get great portability with a screen that's bigger than your phone, but not gigantic and awkward to use. It's a great multitasker for watching shows, reading ebooks, playing games, taking notes, sketching drawings, and probably a ton of things I didn't even think to try. I could see this being great for students using digital textbooks, but keep in mind that it doesn't have support for any of Apple's branded keyboards, but you can use a Bluetooth keyboard. There's also a few things holding it back from being a complete tablet. While the screen is nice, it doesn't get super bright, so outdoor use could be a little tougher if you go for the cellular model. The other thing holding the mini back is the starting price of $499. This would be great for kids, but at that price point, it's going to hurt when they destroy this thing in the first week. It's also way overpriced if you're, say, an avid reader looking for a mostly dedicated e-reader that can jump on the internet from time to time. Look, I'm not a tablet person, so this wasn't made for me in the first place, but a lot of people buy tablets, and Apple makes the highest quality tablets you can buy. And I'm willing to bet if you've already been looking into buying one of these, you already have a good idea of what you can use it for and how you'll enjoy it. I feel like this was made for you. Anyways, that's all I've got for today. As always, thank you for watching, and hey, if you like stupid videos with way too many old jokes and usually newish tech, think about subscribing. Until next time.